Hey, love bugs, it is Rosalyn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed today. I'm doing blessed and highly favored and hope the same for you. And if this is your first time coming to my channel, much love to you and welcome. And for my extended family, thank you so much for the love and support that you send me every day. The positive vibes you give me is so greatly appreciated. And for that being said, namaste. Much love and light, love and blessings, and many blessings you get to come. Thank you so much for stopping by my channel. And if you have been watching my videos and have not already, what are you waiting for? Like and subscribe, even hit that notification bell at the bottom so you know when your girl's about to upload my next video. And if you feel like you're comfortable enough, drop me a line. I would love the chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me, even if it's about the positive feedback of my video or the content of my video, or you just telling me about how you are with your empathic gift. It'll greatly be appreciated. And if you enjoy what you heard or resonate with what you heard, spread the word, give a thumbs up, like, and even share. And thank you so much for stopping by my channel today. The meditation video I'm listening to is called Breathe Namaste. They have so many different, whatever kind of vibe you are feeling with when look, I need a meditation, what do I pick? And they have a long list. It's like calming heart, clearing your aura, just breathe, calmness, oneness, anything you're looking for, loveness, they got it. You want it, they got meditation galore. But today my video is about Twin Flame 101. Empaths, you are the author to your book. Make it a bestseller. Make it a bestseller. You are only you. If you don't take care of you, who's gonna do that? And it's just like so many of us, we have been through so many things where we have helped out people. We have been there. We have been over backwards, been there like 220% and probably got about 10% back. We're just trying to understand, what did I do wrong? Why did these people leave me? Why did they do this? Why did they do that? But you cannot worry about that, because God wipes out things that is no longer serving us. They take us out of toxic relationships. They take us away from people that mean us harm, or any kind of negative impact they can make on your life. Just think about that blessing. You can look back and think about what God has stopped from. Could have happened now. You never know. People be boo-hooing. I want to see this person. I want to see that. I see reality shows where they're upset because, their significant other is, away, or they're doing things they want to do, and they just get upset, and they don't realize that is God's blessing for you to heal yourself, find that confidence and that strength in yourself. Everybody has a story that needs to be told. When I talk to my friends that are that I'm on a personal level with, and we talk about the things we went through in life, and you're just like, God, dog, you know what? We all got something in common. We all went through the hell. It results out of some of these things. People have lost their way. People have got stuck in doing things they're not supposed to do. I've been there. I've lost my way at times. Did not know where I was going. But if I didn't have the people that wiped out of my life, I wouldn't have gained new family and friends. I wouldn't have found the people that are on the same level with me. And not having any motives or cruel intentions towards me. It's just all keeping it real, it's good. It feels good. And when I can look at things that I've done and I've accomplished in life, it might not seem much to the next person, but I think I came a long way. I came a long way. And it's just like when I want to be on my path and be able to tell my story and be able to have, my grandchildren, my children, I want them to be able to look at their great-grandmother and their mother, or whatever I am to them, and just say, she really did a good thing. She has really made an impact on the world, just by telling her story. It has helped a lot of people, just to let them know they're not by themselves. You have your own story to tell. You don't know what kind of impact just your story can do for somebody that is lost along their way. It's just like, I went through this, I went through that, but I overcame that. I'm a survivor from this. I got the battle scars. I got the emotional scars to prove this to you. Even though you don't really have to prove nothing to nobody, but when they have gone through their life and and they're not grateful for things that they've been through, and they're just like, why me, woe is me, you know, nobody, you know, everybody has problems. Like, you know, I used to get upset when I, you know, I could be going through things, and I would have people hit me up or think about me or whatever when I was going through certain things, and they knew I was, but then I couldn't get upset because just because I'm that way doesn't mean the next person is going to be the same way I am. So I can't fault them for that. You know, that's how they are. They're showing me how they truly are. And you can't get mad when, you know, Maya Angelou said, when they show you who they truly are, you better believe them. I promise you, you better believe them. So it's just like when you're on your journey, you know, you have, nobody has control over your life but you. Nobody. Even though we're not really free, but you're free to respond and react, and you have your own free will. And, you know, angels, universe cannot intervene on that unless you ask them to, even though they might intervene on helping us, you know, make sure we stay out of danger and stuff like that. But when it comes to ultimate, they can't do anything without our, you know, asking for that request. So it's just like when I get stuck and I try to find the answers to things that I try to do on my own, I look up and, you know, I can't find the answer. You know, just tell me, give me a sign. Tell me a sign, you know, that I need to know something. You know, but it's just like you're the bestseller of your book. You write the chapter. If you don't like how that is going, rewrite it. You can do that. You know, step yourself out that prison with the key, with the open door. You know, you can do this. You have that strength inside yourself. Stop running from things that you know you clearly need to handle. You clearly need to let go of. And there's things I have to tell myself that every day. So just know you are not on your own. We are all going through this together. It's just we're all fighting different things at the same time. That we're, you know, we're going through our test. You know, it might seem that, you know, God's not listening to us, but you know, teachers always provide a test. You know, it has to be done. You know, He has put these lessons of life amongst us each and every day, every second of our breath. And then when it comes time for that test, are you going to be able to pass? Are you going to be able to write that bestseller that, you know, everybody wants to read? So remember that. Find that courage. Find that hidden strength that you have. That see things that other people see or dare not to see, or they're scared to see because they see that light in you that you don't see for yourself. Light that mess up and keep it moving. Find that light in that tunnel. You'll be okay. And I will talk to you on my next video. Keep me in your prayers. I will definitely do the same for you. Like and subscribe. Hit that notification bell. Drop me a line. I'd love to hear from you. Send out as much love and positive vibes as you possibly can. And I will see you on my next video. Peace and be wild. Stay blessed and prosperous.